She's been looking into it. Bonnie, we've sort of been going through this all day. First, somebody said it was a Cessna, then it was a Cirrus plane. Now authorities have confirmed that it's a Piper PA-28, very much like the one you're standing beside.
That's right, and those are the planes that you mentioned are actually very similar models to this one. And this one's not the exact plane that flew into the building, but it is a picture of the same sort of model. And I'm going to open up the picture a little bit so you can see a close up what it looks like. Why don't we zoom in right here? This plane has four seats, though it could hold about six people, as you can see in the picture. But what we are looking at is the plane itself and the flight path as we take a look at Google Earth. We're going to start off with where the flight originated from, and what you're looking at here is the Georgetown Airport. The distance, as we kind of zoom it up here and fly down, you can see is not that far from the crash site. Let's zoom in here and you can take a look at what we're looking at. Basically, it's important to note the distance is only 20 miles, 7.8 miles from downtown Austin, and we can show you that path as well. Now we're zooming into the crash site, so close to the highway. And incidentally, Ali, I took a look at the weather conditions at the time of the crash, and they were really calm. Visibility was at 10 miles. The temperature was in the low 50s, and it was perfectly clear. Winds at the time of the crash were light out of the south. We did see a lot of that smoke blowing onto the highway. At the time, as the hours continued, we did see those winds become more bearable and pick up with a little bit intensity, but overall weather's not a huge factor here in terms of what was going on at the crash site.
All right, and you and I talked about this when this first happened, because when you're flying a small plane like that, unnaturally high winds could have an impact on it, but that wasn't. We were trying to rule out weather as a factor in this plane going off course, and of course that's before we realized that there was this note and there was a house on fire, but it seemed like it was a calm day. So if that plane went into the building, that would lend credence to the theories that we've heard from some law enforcement officials and some pilots to say, if that plane went into that building, it's probably because someone was trying to get it into that building.
And it's interesting you mentioned high winds. Most of the country actually dealing with high winds, particularly in the Northeast. So had this happened in a different part of the country today, we would have seen very strong winds. But particularly down in Texas, the weather has been calm, and it will continue to be calm in the Austin area as we go into the evening hours.
All right, Bonnie Schneider, thank you for that
update.
Sure.